everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe my channel. Today, in this video, we learn about rate law, law of mass action, rate constant, characteristics of rate constant, order of reaction, molecularity of reaction, order and molecularity of reaction, and at the last in this video, I'll show you some interesting questions, the questions which are conceptual based. So let's begin. In our previous video, we studied that the rate of a reaction depends on both concentration as well as the product. Decrease in rate of concentration with time, that also determines the rate of the reaction, and increase in the concentration of product with time, that also determines the rate of the reaction. But later on, when experiment goes on, it was found that rate of reaction also decreases with time. Now what does this mean? This means that the rate of the reaction depends only upon the concentration of the reactant. The relationship between the concentration of the reactant and the rate of the reaction was first studied by two scientists. Their name were Gulberg and Waage. They gave a law which is known as law of mass action. Now, according to law of mass action, the rate of a reaction is directly proportional to the concentration, molar concentration. Molar concentration of the reactant, each term raised to the power which is same as that written in the balanced chemical equation as a stoichiometric coefficient. Now, what this meaning, stoichiometric coefficient? Stoichiometric coefficient means the numbers which are used in a balanced chemical equation to balance the equation, these numbers are referred as stoichiometric coefficient. For example, N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. So here, 3 and 2 are the stoichiometric coefficient. Now, if we talk about law of mass action, what is rate? Rate of the reaction? Rate of the reaction for the ammonia is directly proportional to the concentration of N2 multiplied by concentration of H2 ki power 3. This is according to law of mass action. But experimentally, it was determined that it is not necessary that in each and every reaction, rate of the reaction depends on the concentration of the reactant raised to the power which is equal to the stoichiometric coefficient. Let us consider a general reaction. AA plus BB gives product. Now, according to law of mass action, what is rate of reaction for this reaction? Is directly proportional to concentration of A to the power A and B to the power B. But suppose experimentally it is found that alpha moles of A and beta moles of B decide the rate of the reaction. Then the rate of the reaction becomes directly proportional to concentration of A to the power alpha and concentration of B to the power beta. Means out of A moles of A, only alpha mole is responsible for determining the rate of the reaction, and out of B moles of B, only beta moles are there for determining the rate of the reaction. So here we got a new expression, that is rate is directly proportional to concentration of A to the power alpha and concentration of B to the power beta. This expression represents our rate law. So what is rate law? Rate law is the law which states that the rate of a reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant, each term raised to the power, raised to some power which may or may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient. Clear? Now, what does this mean? This means that we cannot determine rate law theoretically. We have to determine rate law experimentally. Because we theoretically not able to determine that how many moles are responsible for determining the rate of the reaction. Okay, now what is the expression according to law of mass action or according to law of rate law? Rate is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactants. Now, if we remove this proportionality constant by K, it means it is a constant. So, the expression becomes rate is equals to K into concentration of the reactant. Now, what does this K mean? This K means rate constant. Clear? Now, if we take the molar concentration of each reactant as unity, if we take the molar concentration of each reactant as unity, what our expression becomes? Rate equals to K. Because our expression is rate equals to K concentration of reactant. Now, we are taking concentration of reactant as 1, so our equation becomes rate equals to K. Here, we will define K, that is rate constant. Rate constant is the rate of a reaction when we take the molar concentration of all reactants as unity. So this is the definition of our rate constant. That's why the rate constant is also known as specific reaction rate. Why? Because it becomes equal to the rate of the reaction when we'll take the molar concentration as unity. That's why it is termed as specific reaction rate. Now, the next topic is characteristics of K, means characteristics of rate constant. Now, if the value of K increases, means the rate of the reaction is faster. If the value of K is greater, if we have two reactions, for first reaction the value of K is 2 and for second reaction the value of K is 3. So, it means that in second reaction, the rate of the reaction is faster. So, we can determine the rate of the reaction by using the value of rate constant. Second characteristics of rate constant is, if we talk about a single reaction, suppose if we talk about the formation of ammonia at a particular temperature, the rate constant becomes same. Means the rate constant doesn't depend upon the concentration of the reactant. Clear? Means for a particular reaction at a particular temperature, the value of rate constant becomes constant. But if we change the temperature, then the rate constant value also changes, though the reaction becomes same. If we talk about the formation of ammonia at 200 degrees Celsius, its value of K is suppose K1. At 200 degrees Celsius, if we change the concentration of N2 and H2, its value remains 200. But if we increase the temperature, then its value also changes. Now, we learn about a new term, that is order of the reaction. Now, what do you mean by the order of the reaction? In rate law expression, the sum of the powers of the concentration of the reactant is known as order of the reaction. Let us take an example. 2NO plus O2 gives 2NO3. There is a reaction. Now, according to law of mass action, rate is directly proportional to concentration of NO ki power 2 multiplied by concentration of O2 ki power 1. So, if we add the power, it comes 3, means the order of the reaction should be 3. But when we determine experimentally, the order becomes 2. Why? Because rate of the reaction is directly proportional to concentration of NO ki power 1 and concentration of O2 to the power 1. So 1 plus 1 becomes 2. So what is order of reaction? Order of reaction is the sum of the powers of the concentration of the reactant, which is expressed in rate law, not in law of mass action. This determines our order. Let us take one more example. C2H4. It reacts with H2 to give C2H6. This is hydrogenation of ethene. Now, according to balanced chemical equation, what should be the order of the reaction? Yes, it should be 2. Because the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of C2H4 multiplied by concentration of H2. Both to the power 1. So 1 plus 1 becomes 2. But actually the order is only 1. Why? Because when we determined experimentally, it was found that the rate of the reaction is depends only and only upon the concentration of C2H4. That's why its order becomes first. And on the basis of the order, we can classify reaction as zero order reaction, first order reaction, second order reaction, third order reaction, and fractional order reaction also. Means an order of a reaction may be zero, may be positive, or may be in fraction. Now, there is one more term which is nearly similar to the order. Means there is a little bit difference between order and molecularity. The term is, yes, molecularity. We know there are two types of reaction, elementary reactions and complex reactions. Those reactions which occur in a single steps, they are known as elementary reaction. But it is not necessary that every reaction occur in a single step. For example, formation of oxygen from ozone. This is not a single step reaction. So, some reaction occur in a single step, they are known as elementary reaction, and some reactions which do not occur in a simple steps or single steps, they are known as complex reaction. Now, according to collision theory, in 11th, we heard about this kinetic theory of collision, kinetic molecular theory of collision. According to collision theory, different reactants simultaneously come close to each other, collide with each other and form products. So, what is molecularity? The number of atoms, the number of ions, or the number of molecules which comes together simultaneously at one time to form products by collision, the number is known as molecularity of the reaction. So, molecularity of the reaction is the number of the atoms or ions or molecules of a reaction which come together simultaneously within a time, collide properly and form reactant. This number is known as molecularity of a reaction. Now, if we talk about elementary reactions, in elementary reactions, these are a simple reaction. In elementary reactions, the number of the molecules or the number of the atoms which are written in the balanced chemical equation, they simply comes together, collide and form products. Means, in these cases, molecularity becomes equal to the sum of the stoichiometric coefficient. But in complex reaction, though complex reaction is a combination of different elementary reactions, lots of elementary reactions are there, when they combine, they form a complex reaction. So, there is no meaning of molecularity for a complex reaction. Means, we'll define molecularity only and only in elementary reaction, will not determine molecularity in complex reactions. Now, there is one question that if many reactions are there in one reaction, then how we are able to determine the rate of that particular reaction? So, the answer is, if a number of reactions are there in a single reaction, a reaction is the slowest reaction among them, and that slowest reaction determines our rate of reaction. For example, if we talk about a factory which manufactures cycle, which manufactures bicycle, different parts of bicycle are prepared. Now, the part which takes the longest time to prepare, that part decides how many bicycles are prepared in a particular day. Similarly, in complex reaction, the slowest step determines the rate of the reaction. Now, next topic is the difference between order and molecularity. Though both the terms are similar, but there is a little bit difference in both the terms, and that means a lot. Order. First of all, define order. Now, what is order? Order is the sum of the power of the concentration of reactant, which is written in rate law expression. Now, what is molecularity? Molecularity is the number of atoms, ions or molecules which collides simultaneously to form reactant, to form product. Now, second difference, that order is determined experimentally, but molecularity can be determined theoretically. How? If we know the slowest step or if we know the elementary reaction, then by simply counting the number of the coefficients, we can able to find out the molecularity. So order is experimentally we will find, and molecularity theoretically we will find. Next point, if we change the temperature, if we change the pressure, order also changes. But if we change the temperature or if we change the pressure, molecularity remains same. It means order is variable, whereas molecularity is invariable. Next point is, order is applicable for both type of reaction. Simple, that is elementary reactions, as well as complex reactions. But molecularity means only and only for simple reaction. There is no meaning of molecularity for complex reaction. So these four are the points which is the difference between order and molecularity.
Guys, in the beginning of this video, I promised you to tell you some interesting questions. I have two interesting questions for you. We learn about order. I told you that we have zero order reaction, we have first order reaction, we have second order reaction, we have third order reaction, even we have fractional order reaction also. But after that, the order becomes very rare. Means the reactions of higher order are very rare. Now the question is why? So our first question is why the reactions of higher order are very rare. Now this answer is based on the collision theory. According to collision theory, reactants come close to each other simultaneously, they will collide with each other and then they will convert into products. But due to the increase in the order, higher order means number of reactants increases, and if the number of reactant increases, the chances of perfect collision becomes decreases. Clear? Means if a crowd is there, then the chance to occur a perfect collision decreases, and if the chance to perfect collisions decreases, then tendency to convert into product also decreases, and this is the reason why reaction of high order are very rare. Now the second question is, in your books, in zero order reaction, there is one example that the decomposition of ammonia on a hot platinum surface at a high pressure is an example of zero order reaction. But this reaction may also be an example of first order reaction. So this is the question, that how a reaction be zero order reaction as well as first order reaction. The whole role was played by pressure. If we perform this reaction at high pressure, actually this is a reversible reaction. In reversible reaction, we have forward as well as backward reaction. So we have two rate constant, K1 and K2. So the actual rate of the reaction for this reaction is rate is equals to K1 concentration of NH3 divided by 1 plus K2 concentration of NH3, where K1 and K2 are different rate constant. Clear? Now if we talk about high pressure, means the pressure of ammonia is very high, and because this reaction ammonia is present in gaseous form, nitrogen is present in gaseous form, and hydrogen is also present in gaseous form. Therefore, the rate becomes K pressure of NH3, because in gaseous reactions we'll take pressure in terms of molar concentration. So rate becomes K pressure of NH3 1 plus K2 pressure of NH3. Clear? Now, at high pressure means the pressure of NH3 is very high. If the pressure of NH3 is very high, then the value of K2 multiplied by pH3 is very high or very large as compared to 1. So, 1 can be neglected. If 1 can be neglected, then the reaction becomes rate is equals to K1 pressure of NH3 divided by K2 pressure of NH3. Why? Because 1 is neglected as compared to the value of this. Now, the pressure of NH3 is same in both cases. So, it will cancel each other. What we got? We got K1 divided by K2. Now, what is K1? K1 is rate constant. What is K2? K2 is also constant. Constant divided by constant is also a constant. That's why at high pressure, the rate of the reaction depends only on rate constant, and that's why at high pressure this value or this reaction is an example of zero order reaction. Now, if we talk about low pressure, means the value of 1 is very, very, very greater than the value of pNH3. It means we can neglect the value of K2pH3 and we'll able to K2pNH3, and our equation become, our rate become rate equals to K1pNH3 divided by 1. Clear? Now here the rate depends on rate constant as well as the pressure of the NH3 raised to power 1. And because of this, this is first order reaction. So, reaction is same, but if we talk about high pressure, the reaction is an example of zero order. And if we are talking about low pressure, the reaction is an example of first order. Now, there is one more topic which I left earlier. Unit of rate constant of different order. Now, we know that rate of the reaction is the change in concentration divided by time, means we can express rate as dx divided by dt, where dx is the change in the concentration and dt is the time taken. And according to law of mass action or rate law, rate is equals to k concentration ki power n. In both the way, we can able to define rate. So, if rate equals to dx by dt and if rate equals to k into concentration to the power n, then obviously dx by dt is equals to k concentration to the power n. Now, what k meant then? K is equals to dx by dt multiplied by 1 upon concentration to the power n. K concentration becomes here. Now, what is dx? Dx is the change in concentration. And what is the unit of concentration? Concentration is mole per liter. So it's unit, so it is concentration divided by time multiplied by 1 upon concentration. Clear? Now, concentration to the power n. Here is concentration, here is also concentration. So it becomes concentration 1 minus n. Clear? Divided by time. Now, what is the value of concentration? What is the unit of concentration? That is mole per liter. And what is the value of time? That is second. Now, putting the value as 0, 1, 2, 3 on the basis of the order of the reaction, we can able to determine the unit of rate constant for different orders. For example, if we have to calculate the unit of rate constant for 0 order. For 0 order, the value of n becomes 0. Now, if we put the value of n 0 here, it becomes k equals to concentration 1 minus 0 divided by time. 1 minus 0 becomes 1. So it's concentration divided by time. Now, what is the formula of concentration? Formula of concentration is mole per liter. And what is the formula, unit of time? That is either second inverse or minute inverse. So it is mole per liter per second or mole per liter per minute. So in this way, we can able to calculate the unit of rate constant for zero order reaction, first order reaction or second order reaction. Got it?
Okay guys, that's all for today. See you in my next video. If you have any query related to my video, then give your question or give your feedback in the comment section. I'll reply. Thank you.